at our spring concert and art show. Hope you got a chance to check out some of the amazing artwork in our hallway. We're going to go ahead and jump right on in with a little special performance.
A special song.
Thank you. Before moving off Broadway. In the song Pulled, Wesley Adams is struggling with feelings that are pulling her away from the traditional Adams family demeanor. Boy may or may not be involved, we hope you enjoy Pulled.
Being pulled. The song Beyond the Sea was an English language version of Charles Trenet's 1946 classic Lomer, featuring lyrics by Jack Lawrence, which turned an original conceptual ode to the sea into a song about love and longing. Bobby Darin recorded Beyond the Sea in the midst of his transition from being a singer of cheesy rock songs into Rat Pack style, big band swing, and jazz territory. It also followed the success of his version of Mack the Knife from the Threepenny Opera, releasing earlier that year. As mentioned, Beyond the Sea is known today as one of Darwin's signature songs. We hope you enjoy Beyond the Sea.
We all rise, we all rise.
life experiences, but always remembering where you came from and knowing you can always return home. The question is, where is the speaker going? Where are they? Why are they coming home? And where is home to them? Are we graduating and flying off to jobs or college? Is home a place, a person, an afterlife? How will you interpret the lyrics?
Thank you all so much. I get a little bit of time to talk while our band comes on up. That's your cue. Thanks again. So in just in that first little bit of music, we've heard like at least two different languages, which is pretty cool. We're gonna hear some more coming up with our chamber choir in the last half. I got a lot of guff for this concert from the kids for not having a theme for this concert. So I'm like looking for everything like, okay, more languages maybe. Anyway, I just want to again say thank you so much for being here. While our band is getting ready, we tried something new this concert. So our Tryon Music Honor Society was coming up with some ideas towards the end of the year of something we could do for a little service opportunity. And one of the ideas they came up with was having a little raffle for like a fine arts voucher. So you can purchase tickets out in the front. Eric Hu, right? Raise your hand, Eric. You chose the ticket, correct?
Yeah.
Could you say that any less confidently? He did choose it. So our winner is, and they actually wrote it on the back here for us, Mrs. Bianco. Round of applause. And all the money that we were raising, we're going to the Chicago Music Box Foundation, which is an awesome foundation downtown Chicago, supporting after-school music activities. So thank you. If you bought a ticket, I do appreciate it. So I'll see you afterwards with Mrs. Bianco. Here we go. Here's your band.
It's time.
Thank you.
The piece on Shoulders of Giants includes many musical quotes from a Lincoln portrait by American composer Aaron Copland. The themes are centered around the idea that the fate of the country lies in the hands of our elected officials. In the words of the composer, my hope is that we've armed them with vision, determination, and optimism as well. May they stand on the shoulders of giants and reach heights we never could have imagined.
Thank you. Mr. Klose's favorite band composer is Gustav Holst. A promise that he can make is that the band will perform a Holst piece every year. This year, we are playing two of the four movements of Holst's Second Suite in F for Military Band. The piece was written in 1911 and at a time when Holst was exhausted with the thought of writing new material. Through the entire suite, Holst weaves in over a dozen folk tunes from Great Britain and the surrounding area. We hope you enjoy March and Fantasia of the Dargison from the Second Suite in F. I don't know how to say Fantasia, we just call it Dargison.
Thank you.
Just real quick, Cass. Folks, we have just a couple seniors this year graduating. And you might be asking yourself, like, wow, there's only like four kids graduating. Well, back in their freshman year, we were in COVID. And so we were talking before the concert today. The seniors now, their freshman year, we were in maroon and gold cohorts. And we had band class here in the auditorium, 9 feet on either side of us and in front of us from the next person. We had masks and bell covers on our instruments. We had to play with masks on. Wasn't, as you remember, not a very social time. But we have a couple of seniors that stuck with it, even though it was not very fun, even though it was not a traditional band environment. And I just want to take a minute to recognize them. And I feel like, you know, especially if you come to these, like every year we like recognize our seniors, but like they really do stick with us. I saw an old graduate in the hall right before here, Nora, and like I'm using your guys' baton tonight. So like you guys, students, you really do have an impact on our lives as much as we have an impact on your lives. So I'd like to take just a minute. Andre's not here tonight. You can find his little bio in your program, but Paulino, Colin, and Cass here. If you guys can stand up. If we give them a round of applause, recognize them. I just have a little token of appreciation for you.
It's an A, you all get A's. In case you didn't get enough of the sound music earlier this spring, hopefully this will satisfy your itch. The band will be performing My Favorite Thing by Rodgers and Hammerstein. We hope you enjoy this performance. Thank you.
composer Victor C. Johnson was on a trip to Zambia. He worked with some choir students who introduced him to the traditional song, Bonseyabo. Loosely translated, the song means, all who sing with the spirit have a right to be called the children of God. It soon became one of his favorites because of the upbeat rhythm and then meaning. We hope you enjoyed the chamber choir's rendition of Bonseyabo.
Text for this love song. Neither of them expected the song to take this particular direction. Using Silvestri's own personal loss, the two created this beautiful, powerful, and uplifting song. Through loss, love remains. Let this song and its words be a sentiment of hope and healing.
Thank you. Little Stevie Wonder first grabbed the pop charts and the hearts of America in the 1960s with hits like Uptight and For Once in My Life. He went on to write and record 9 top hits throughout that decade. Stevie Wonder got his start at Motown Records and is still the only original artist signed with the record label. We hope you enjoy the Stevie Wonder medley.
Everything is over.
Appalachian tune, "Will the Circle Be Unbroken," was originally recorded by the Carter family in 1935. In addition to some lyric changes, you will hear a new rendition featuring a bluegrass trio of R.C. Pozo, Sammy Menefees, and Mary Faith Consolide.
Will the circle be unbroken by and by, Lord, by and by? There's a better home awaiting if we try, Lord, if we try. I was singing with my sisters. I was singing with my friends. And we all can sing together, 'cause the circle never ends.
I was singing
with my sisters,
and my brothers.
I was singing
with my friends,
and we all can sing together.
The circle never ends.
Oh, will the circle be unbroken by and by, Lord, by and by? There's a better home awaiting if we try, Lord.
Check 1, 2. Folks, we have one last song for you tonight. Thank you so much for taking the time out of your schedule to be here, to support Music at Montini. We really do appreciate it. I'm going to turn over to Sammy Menefees and introduce our last piece.
In the words of the composer, Kyle Peterson, he thought about researcher/author Breen Brown's timely and poignant writing on the idea of enoughness, and reflected how badly we need young people who feel and believe that they are indeed enough, comfortable in their own skin, not dependent on others for their identity, confident in their own choices and abilities, willing to be vulnerable in sharing emotion and insecurities when they arise, and able to lean into strong, healthy friendships. The text explores these various themes through the lens of two young people having a conversation about finding their way in a difficult world. We hope you enjoy Does the World Say?
Does the world say that you don't look the right way? Does the world say that you're just not enough?
Does the world say that you're not in the right spot when it
wants you there but not here, and tells you all the things you are not.
We hope you guys have a wonderful end of the year. Thank you again.